Good morning, children. How are you? I trust that you're okay with your parents, with your siblings, and you're doing the work of the Holy Spirit and practicing the fruits of the Holy Spirit. Well, today we are prepared for you so many good things, things that are even going to make you happy. Celebrate, you know, even celebrating the body of Christ. It's also something, yeah, something unique. Now we have, last time we talked about the fruits of the Holy Spirit. We have faithfulness, we have gentleness, we have self-control, we have kindness, goodness, peace, patience, joy, and love. Oh, can you remember that? I hope you're remembering those fruits of the Holy Spirit. Please let us practice all this. And when you have this, everything is fine. And even the Holy Spirit, Jesus, God himself will be happy with you. So my children, now it's a time that now we have so many things. You see, like we have ball, you can play ball. Yeah, we have so many toys. Ah, so exciting. And now it is time to pray. Let us fold our hands and pray.
Good morning, children. I want to greet you all in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. How are you? Hope you are doing, you are keeping safe at home, and the Lord has continued to bless you wherever you are. We are missing you in church, and we know the Lord will give us an opportunity very soon. We shall be back again. I want us now to pray. May you close your eyes so that we are able to pray together with you. Let us pray. Our Father and our God, we are so grateful this wonderful morning, this Sunday that you have given us, O God. It is another new morning, and we know, dear Father, you have opened us up for a special purpose. This is the day that you set apart, the seventh day, so that we worship you and praise you. And we know, Lord, even though we are not going to church and to the churches, you are everywhere. Even at home, you are still there, O God. How I pray for you, our young children, for the way the Lord has taken care of you. He has protected you from the pandemic, and we are giving thanks for what he has done. Even today, we pray, Father, that you continue to keep these children safe, you continue to watch over them, you continue to lead them and to help them, O God, to overcome any challenge they may be going through. Dear Lord, I pray that these children who continue to grow knowing you, in knowledge of you, God, and dear Father, they will not be led astray by the enemy, the devil. I pray, Father, that they may not receive any wrong teachings. Even when they get those wrong teachings, O God, you take them away from them so that they may be right with you and they may walk in your ways, O dear Father. I commit them now to you. Lord, you may continue blessing them, providing for them every need that they have. May you meet it according to your riches in glory. Though this time has been a very difficult time, even as they enjoy their Easter holiday, dear Father, due to this pandemic, it has not been easy, but Lord, you have been there supporting us and supporting our children. I pray, Father, that you will continue teaching them your ways, and Lord, they will never leave you, even when they are old. Now, Father, I also remember their parents as you bless these children. May you also bless their parents, wherever they are, and Lord, even in their works, may you bless them. your prayers this morning, even as these children sit down and settle to hear their lesson of God being taught by their teachers. May you, Lord, speak to them and bless them. Hear our prayers, O God, for you are a faithful God, a faithful Father who always hears us. And this is our prayer. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. Thank you, children. God bless you.
God bless Mommy. God bless Daddy. God bless Teacher. Help me always to make them happy. To make them happy.
Hi, welcome to PCEA Umoja Kids. My name is Edith Minari.
Hi, I'm Juliet Kudoga.
And I am Samuel. Guys, welcome to this dance. You can join us in the dance.
Brothers and sisters, I want to welcome you back to life, back to the one that can make your next chapter your best chapter. Hallelujah.
How can it be that you love the most unlovable part of me?
Help me
to see like you, no matter what I go through.
Yeah. superheroes. A love like this
makes my heart beat.
And I promise you,
all I wanna do is make you proud of me.
That's why
I don't wanna love nobody but you. I don't wanna love nobody but you.
Yes.
I don't wanna love nobody, love nobody but you.
Yes. And the church saying, come on. Jesus loving means
more than less of me.
That's why
I don't wanna love nobody but you, nobody but you.
Let me tell you what he does.
He saves the day.
Come on.
He will come through.
He will let you down, but
all I wanna do is make you proud of me.
Everybody sing.
I don't wanna love nobody but you. I don't wanna love nobody but you.
Yes.
I don't wanna love nobody but you.
Good morning, boys and girls. This is another bright morning that the Lord has given unto us. And indeed, you know, we always meet on Sunday. Why? Because we want to learn the word of God. And before we continue with the lesson, let's say a word of prayer. Our Father and our God, in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we bow before you this morning. We commit the lesson before you. We pray, dear Lord, at the end of the lesson, we shall have learned something. And Lord, our Father, will transform even our hearts. This is prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Morning, boys and girls, again. Today's lesson is entitled Unity and Diversity in the Body of Christ. Unity and Diversity in the Body of Christ. And our leading, we are going to get the text from 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 12 to 31. 1 Corinthians chapter 12 to 31. The writer Paul is talking about diversity and also unity. What is diversity? Diversity is you're different in culture, you're different in social life, you're different in language, you're different in the language you speak, the way you do things, we are different. But the Apostle Paul uses the body of Christ to illustrate the way we are supposed to be, diversity, but at the same time, we are united. So the Apostle Paul uses the body, the human body. And you, all of us, we know the body, our body. See, we know the body parts. Yeah, the body has so many parts. The body has so many parts. It's one body, but different parts. And of course, from our chart, you can tell me, and you know these things. You know, we have ears, we have nose, we have our hands, we have the head, you have, what else do you have? Yes, even the shoulder. Yes, and you always remember, we have that one song that says, head, shoulders, knees, and toes, they all belong to who? They all belong to Jesus. What I want us to learn today is that though we are different, I mean, though the body is one, and though we are different, we can work together. We can do what? We can work together. We are wired differently, we are talented differently, but we can work in unity. Yes, because let me ask you, one day I met a girl on the road. She was crossing the road slowly, slowly, slowly. And when I looked at her closely, she was limping because her toe was hurting. She had been kicked by a stone when she was going to school. She was playing football, I guess, because she didn't have shoes. So the toe was hurting. So when she was now crossing the road slowly, because the toe was hurting, she was crying, she was in tears because one toe, a small part of the body, was hurting. So the entire body was suffering. And now they wanted to go where? They wanted to go to the hospital. Now you see the importance of the body is when one part of the body is suffering, they all go and make sure that one toe is treated and they are back normally. Yes, as we go on, remember the Apostle Paul in the text, he says, the hand cannot say to the foot, I don't need you. And then again, the hand cannot say that, you know, I'll be the whole body. Because Apostle Paul says, if the whole body was the hand, where could be the rest of the parts of the body? If the hand was the body, where could the ears be? Where could the eyes be? Yeah, if the whole body was the leg, imagine. Ati mwili yote hivi ni mguu moja inatembea hivyo. Ehe? Nayo mdomo itakuwa wapi? Si ndio? So, we need every part of the body. We need every part of the body. And then the Apostle Paul continued to say that every part of the body, no matter how small, the finger is so small. The finger is so small. But imagine, we need the finger. Or do you think you don't need the finger? We do. Yes, the ear also is not a big part of the body. But imagine, we need the ear. So every part of our body, Apostle Paul says that they are all treated equally. They are all treated equally because they all are needed in the body so that the body may function properly. Imagine if the Mr. Stomach was not there. Aya, where would you store your food? Where would the digestion be? Wow, what about if the ear was not there? Utatembea hivi husikii kitu. Kwa sababu the ear is not there. So, Apostle Paul continued to say that all the body parts, they are treated equally. And you know also what the Apostle Paul says, they have no division. The body parts have no division. The body parts have no division. Like now, the leg cannot tell the hand, ebu tuende tutoke kwa mwili. Mr. Kikutembea, you know, the heart cannot say, I'll go with the ear, I'll go with the eye, and then we leave the other part of the body. They have no division. You cannot divide the body because God created them the way he wanted to create them. So every part of the body needs the other. Every part of the body needs the other for the good of the whole body. For the good of the whole body. So, Apostle Paul continued to say, there is no division in the body of Christ, in our bodies. So, we need to treat each other so well and also with respect. Then, Apostle Paul continued to say that if one part of the body suffers, like I've told you the story, the girl, the toe was hurting. So, if one part of the body, no matter how small, if it suffers, the whole body suffers. The whole body is in pain and they cannot rest. Have you ever had a toothache, boys and girls? Hey, ushaisikia hiyo uchungu ya meno? Mimi nimeshaisikia. Huwezi lala because the entire head, the entire body is in pain. So, every part of the body, when one part of the body suffers, the entire body suffers. He continues to say that if one part of the body is honored, if one part of the body is honored, they all rejoice. They are all honored. So when one part of the body is feeling good, when you are in good health, you all rejoice because the entire body is one. So Apostle Paul was comparing the parts of the body to us Christians. To us believers. Then he continued to say, we as believers, you and me, boys and girls, we are the body of Christ. We are the body of Christ. Meaning, you are the leg, or I am the arm, or I am the ear, you are the eye, we are the body of Christ. And being the body of Christ, as I have told you, we need not divide. We did not be honored more than the other. We treat each other equally. Then he continued to say that we are gifted differently. Some are apostles, some are prophets, some are teachers, some work miracles, some are gifted in helping people, some are gifted in doing what? In praying. And all those people are different, yet they are serving the body of Christ. Yes, boys and girls, you and me, we are the body of Christ and we need each other. when you are talented differently, maybe you're able to sing so well, you're able to pray so well, you're able to arrange the church so well, you're able even to, you know, to help the sick so well, and they love you so much. But imagine, we are not supposed to be honored more than the other, because no matter how little thing you do in church or to other people, Christ desires that we all be the same, that we treat everybody the same. Boys and girls, as we come to the end of our lesson today, remember that we are not supposed to be divided. We're supposed to be united, because even when we have different cultures, we speak different languages, we love different foods. Like I know some people love ugali, wengine wanapenda fish, wengine ni modhokoi, wengine ni githeri, wengine tu ni kuku. But imagine, hata kama tunapenda vitu different, hata kama tunaongea language different, we are the body of Christ and we are all equal and we are all the same. This brings us to our memory verse. And our memory verse comes from the book of Galatians 3:28. The book of Galatians 3:28. And it says, there is neither Jew nor Gentile, neither slave nor is free, neither is there a male or female, for you are all in Jesus, in Christ Jesus. For you are all in Christ Jesus. Galatians 3:28. That is our memory verse. Remember that we are neither Jew, we are neither slaves, we are all the same in Jesus Christ. Boys and girls, our song today is also reminding us that we need each other. And it goes like this. You and me, though different, we are the body of Christ. You and me, though different, we are the body of Christ. Therefore, let's pray together, let's pray together, let's dance together, let's rejoice for the sake of Christ. Yes, for the sake of Christ, we will pray together, we will rejoice together, we will dance together. Where you are gifted, enjoy where you are gifted. Yes, enjoy where you are gifted, because we are all the body of Christ. And as we come to the cross, remember, we are talented differently, isn't it? We are talented differently. In church, there are some who sing so well, there are some who read choir, there are some who read the Bible so well. In church, we do different things so well and so differently, isn't it? Even in our social life, we do things differently. We are talented differently. Some are footballers, some are musicians, some are artists, some are, you know, wengine hata wanapenda tu kucheka tu na kufurahia, some are comedians. You see, we are all created differently. God wanted us to be different but work in unity. Isn't it, student boys and girls? So when you see your friend doing something different and better than you, usimu envy, usikuwe na kiwaru, usisikie vibaya, kwa sababu tunatakana, anakufurahia, anarejoice na wewe, na wewe what you can do better, anarejoice na wewe, isn't it? So children, today, I also want to give you some few questions. But before I give you a few questions, in a grant, I want you to name for me the body parts. As I show you these, you show me the body parts. Like here, I've circled the word hand. That is a part of the body. Yes, the hand. And also the ear. Ear, and it is coming from this side to this one. At a glance, I want you to give me one body part. One body part from the password. From the password, I want you to give me one body part. And next time, you'll tell me the one that you got, okay? Thank you, boys and girls. We are going on well, and we are almost coming to the end of the lesson. Let me ask you one or two questions. Can the eye say to the leg, I do not need you? You tell me, yes or no. When one part of the body suffer, do the other parts suffer with it, or do they rejoice? Yes or no? boys and girls, we have come to the end of our lesson today. And even as we have come to the end of our lesson today, I want us to pray. Just take a minute, pray. Tell God, Lord, I want to rejoice with others when they are rejoicing. I want to celebrate others when they are honored, when they are doing good in whatever you have called them to do. I want to rejoice with them. And when some of us are suffering, Lord, I want to suffer with them. Sitaki kuwachekelea wakiumia. Just 1 minute, pray for yourself and tell God to help you so that you be a good part of the body. I know you are praying, boys and girls. Let me pray for you too. Our Father and our God, in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ, today you have taught us that we are created differently. But Lord, our Father, you desire that we work in unity. How we pray, dear Lord, that where you have talented us, O God, we shall be a good ambassador to the others. We shall rejoice with others when they are rejoicing. Yet when they are suffering, Lord, we want also to suffer with them. We want to pray with them. We want to encourage them, God Almighty. We thank you and we bless you because we are going to be good children. We are going to be good ambassadors of the body of Christ. Lord, we love you and we adore you. For this is our prayer of faith in Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen. Wow, beautiful boys and girls. We have come to the end of the lesson. And I believe you are blessed. So when you are talented, work and work. And work. God bless you so much. I'm blessed, and I know you are blessed too. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.